Hey everyone, Sandeep here from 99signals.com, and in this video I'll be doing a review and tutorial of AppMySite, which is an easy to use mobile app builder that helps you convert your website to an iOS or Android app. This is a highly popular tool within the AppSumo community that keeps returning to the AppSumo platform. But this time it's back only for a limited run during the Sumo Day event, which takes place from June 9th to June 13th. So if you want to grab a lifetime deal on AppMySite and convert your website into an engaging mobile app, AppSumo Sumo Day is the best time to do so. With AppMySite's built-in converter, you can convert your WordPress or Shopify website into a mobile app in just a few minutes, or even build a native app from scratch without any prior coding knowledge. Once you're done building the app, you can download it or publish it in Apple's Play Store and Google Play Store directly within AppMySite's platform. Now, if you check AppMySite's pricing on their website, you'll find different options. When it was first listed on AppSumo a couple of years back, you could only find one option, which was WordPress to app. Since then, AppMySite has added several features, and you can now convert any website into a mobile app, regardless of whether it's hosted on WordPress or not. In this video, I'll show you how to convert your WordPress site into a mobile app. So let's check the WordPress pricing. Typically, you'd have to pay $19 a month for AppMySite's starter plan. But during AppSumo Sumo Day event, you can get lifetime access to AppMySite for just $59. Click on the link in the description of this video to learn more about the AppMySite lifetime deal. Remember that it'll be live at AppSumo for just a few more days. With that said, let's dive into the tutorial of AppMySite. Right, the first thing you need to do after logging into your AppMySite account is navigate to Settings. This is where you need to enter your app name and your product details. So if you are trying to convert your WordPress site into a mobile app, then select WordPress app here. You can also select Web2App, WooCommerce2App, or even a custom app where you try to build a native app from scratch. So in this tutorial, we'll be focusing on WordPress to app. So let's select this option. And then you can enter your website URL. And if you have a terms and conditions page, you can enter that here. And once you've done that, you can save your settings. The next step is to install and activate the AppMySite plugin. Either download the plugin from here or just search for it in your WordPress plugin directory. And once you have installed and activated it, you'll get a license key, which you need to copy and paste here. And then you just need to verify the connectivity. And once your WordPress site is connected to AppMySite, you'll see this graphic here, which shows that it's connected. And then you can constantly monitor whether your app is connected to your WordPress site. You can select this option, which is monitor connectivity. And you can also check this option to get email alerts whenever the connectivity fails. So save these settings. Next, click on the design menu option. This is where you can design your app icon and the splash screen. So suppose you don't have the app icon and the splash screen, you can start designing on AppMySite itself. You can use AppMySite's inbuilt graphic designer. So to access the templates, just click on start designing. And you'll find several professionally designed templates here, which you can then customize and give it a look and feel of your website. Alternatively, you can also use Canva. You'll find a lot more templates on Canva, and you can just design a graphic there and upload it on AppMySite. Or to keep it simple, you can simply use the templates that you find on AppMySite and then customize it to give it a look and feel of your own brand. Once your splash screen is ready, you can just save the settings and then move on to navigation. First, start with the color theme of your app. Make sure that it mirrors your site's layout and content. So pick the right font type and then select a primary color and also select a button color. So the whole goal here is to make sure that your app is similar to the layout and design of your website. Once again, save your settings here and then move on to home screen. So these are all the sections that you would want to include in your app. So select the ones that you would like to include and remove the ones that are not necessary. So you may want to remove the main banner, which just displays your app name, so you can hide it. And for each of these sections, you can change the name as well. So you can see that I've changed the name of the blog banner to featured blog post. And each of these sections here, you can rename them to make sure that it aligns with your website's layout and content. Once again, save the settings here and then move on to the menu. Once again, you would want the menu on your app to be similar to that of your website. So make sure you select this option. It'll sync your WordPress menu with your app menu. And out of these three options, you can select the menu that you'd like to display on your app. You also have the option to display your secondary menu and once again, sync it with your WordPress menu. Save your settings and then move on to pages. If you'd like your pages to be seen the same way as they are seen through a mobile browser, then you can select render as web view option. save your settings and then move on to posts. So this is where you can tweak the settings of how your blog is seen on the mobile app. So you can select or deselect some of the options here to change the look and feel of how your blog posts will look in the app. So if you don't want the grid option, you can deselect this option and it will be shown as a list. And when you scroll down to post details, you can control the additional information that is seen with your blog posts. So if you don't want the tags to be shown, you can just deselect this option. You can also deselect show additional information. And if you select this option, which is to show related posts, you can filter the related posts by categories, featured articles, or specific authors. Once you've selected all the options that you would like to include in the app, you can just hit the save button and then move on to the app preview. This is where you can preview your app on different iOS and Android devices. So for Android, you have the option to select Pixel 5 or Nexus 5. On iOS, you have the option to select iPhone 14, iPhone 11, or some of the older iPhone models. You can even preview your app on your existing mobile device. So just select this Test App on Real Device option. On iOS, you can download this app called Test Flight, and you can preview your app there. And on Google Play, AppMySite has its own app. You can just install it on your Android device and see how your app looks on the AppMySite app. Once you're happy with the look and feel of your app, you can go to the download section. So this is where you can start building your app and then download it on Android and iOS. So to get this download option, you need to select the Build App button. Once you've done that, AppMySite will take about 10 to 15 minutes to build your app. And once it's ready, you'll have these two download options. You can download the APK version of your app and then upload it on the Play Store directly, or you can publish the app directly from AppMySite itself. So to do that, select the Publish button here. So to publish it through AppMySite, you'll need to buy a few add-on services. So from my experience, if you want to upload it directly on the Apple Play Store, there is a certain cost involved. 2 to 3 years back, when my app was live on the App Store, I had to pay $99 a year. That may have changed now, but you can buy the one-click publish add-on service here through AppMySite, and you just need to pay $9 a month, and you can upload and deploy your app directly within the AppMySite platform. At the time of doing this review, there's no option for you to directly publish your app on Google Play Store. The best option for you would be to download your app and then upload it directly on Google Play Store. As far as I know, there is no cost involved like the App Store. You can upload your app for free and then it'll go through some moderation. And if there's no problem with your app will be live on Google Play Store. To access the analytics for your app through AppMySite, you'll need to buy an add-on package. Right now, all three plans that AppSumo is offering, there's no option for you to access this feature through the lifetime deal on AppSumo. You'll need to buy an add-on package. But what I would recommend is once your app is live on the Play Store, they'll have their own native analytics, and you can check the performance of your app through their analytics itself rather than buying an add-on package here. Also, if you go with license tier 1, you'll have the AppMySite branding on your app. So if you want to remove that, you can go with license tier 2 or license tier 3. But if you don't have any problems with that, and if you just like to convert your WordPress website into a mobile app, then license tier 1 should be sufficient. You also have the option to build 2 additional apps. But if you have more requirements, if you want to build more apps, then you can go with license tier 2 and license tier 3. They also come with additional features. So depending on your requirement, you can go with any of these options. One final thing before I finish, if you'd like to display your social media pages on the app, you just need to fill in the details here of all your social media pages. And once you've saved your settings here, your social media icons will be displayed on the app. So that's all you need to do to convert your WordPress site into a mobile app. Like I said at the start, it's an easy to use tool and you can convert your WordPress site into a mobile app in just a few minutes. And if you like what you've seen here, you can just go ahead and buy the lifetime deal on AppMySite on AppSumo while it's still available. Like I said, this deal will be live on AppSumo only during the Sumo Day event. So you only have limited time to get lifetime access to AppMySite. You can find the link in the description to the lifetime deal to learn more about all the features that you'll be getting with this lifetime deal. That wraps up this quick tutorial of AppMySite. If you found this video useful, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel for more updates and reviews on trending SaaS tools for entrepreneurs and marketers. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll be back soon.